Now, to record on the USB, you basically arm it by hitting this button here. It's armed it, and it picked the next WAV file, so it's named the next file. We want to tell it where to record from, so we hit options. Well, that's playback, we don't want that. So it looks like we've already selected our source. I can't remember where I selected source. So I can actually start the recording here. Then I can turn something on by unmuting. Oh, that's probably too high. Okay, so it started to record. I think I've selected this stereo mix as a recording source. So then you stop the recording up here. And that should have a new file when we go to do the playback. File 3. Select. And then you can play that one. Except we have to select the preamp. And deselect the inputs. So there you go, that's the playback and record. Alright, after you've formatted the file system on your USB drive, it looks like that, you've got capacity and the file system's okay. You then to iopatch. And I've currently set, what you do is you look at these two there, 17 and 18 are what you're going to record. And if you want to change them, you select them by hitting that. And once it's selected, you can use the rotary to pick another. You might want to go post or any of those, but I want to go pre, and I'm going to go left and right, pre, left and left and right, pre, right for the right hand side. Then you hit apply. Now you go to home, key your drive, that's it. And you'll see there on the inputs we've got left pre and right pre. We can arm it by hitting the red button. It's now armed, ready to go, and it will record whatever's on the left and right pre buses. And we hit that's just started. There you go, it's recording. We've got no input, so just have to unmute everything. Alright, playing back a WAV file I've recorded in the USB. And it appears you've got to use Stereo Layer 3. Stereo Layer 3. So in the layers, you select. Then you go to the preamp, select preamp, switch the preamp on, watch what happens. The VU meters light up, so you know you've got the right output. Then you can start it. And I can use the preamp volume to go up and down. And I can also use Stereo 3 fader. Okay. So that's playback. Alright, I have a effect assigned to channel 3. See, I've got channel 3 selected. And back panel doesn't show it there, but it has this dry wet mix showing, and I can insert or take it out. See, it's been taken out now. I can insert it, and the dry wet mix I can mix with the rotary. That will give you different effects.
E.g., that's the mix. That's the dry. Different, isn't it?
So,
make it completely wet, that's the entire mix.
Then I can turn it off.
Turn it off, just with the insert button.
Right, so that's that. The back panel is where you do that. And this is where you select the effect from the library by hitting the function key. And once you find one you want to insert, you select it. Then you must recall it. Recall says, put this in. Stick it in. And then you get the new settings. That's the default.
The default for that one.
Just switch it on, and it's got an effect. So again, I can select the amount with the wet dry. Alright, so let's not do any more effects, because I don't have them on any other channel. Let's go to channel 1, which is a microphone. Yep, with the radio playing. Select that channel. And go to processing. You can see it's got some input on the VU meter. And we can see preamps set to default. Okay, the default is 28 dB. I've got the 48 volt set on, which is, you set it there. You've got to hold it on and off like that. So if you do that, the input's died because the voltage has gone out of the 48 volts. So I hit the 48 volt phantom power back on. So that the input starts to work again. Okay, other things on this screen are the parametric equal. That's your low and very low frequency settings and the gain, just very standard. You can copy those settings from one channel to another by hitting the copy button, then the channel that you want to copy. You've got to hold down the copy button first. Okay, and I've also set the compressor on this one. Switching to another channel. 16. Obviously that's got a different parametric setting. That doesn't have the phantom power set on. It's got a standard 28 dB on the preamp level, and it's got no delay and no effect. But I'll mention the pan. Use the pan control whenever you're on a particular channel. So that's now set this channel 16 to panning center. I'll demonstrate by going back to channel 1. Notice the pan moves to the right, which is the default that I actually set prior to that. So that's all good. And you set the volume of the faders for the particular mix you're on. This is the main mix. When that's set, all these faders work on the main output. It then remembers those. If you hit now, the what I'm going to use for my fallback is this Mix 910. And those are the settings of the inputs for the fallback that's coming out of channel 10. So you can just go back by hitting left, right, or you can hit, you can switch off the Mix 910 and it goes back to the previous settings. In addition to all the channel volumes and the main mix volume, you can also have layers. So if you set the layer button on, you can select stereo 1, stereo 2, and all this stuff. Now, the one of relevance is stereo 3, which is the one that's used for the input to the USB recording. And the source for that, as we saw before, we've selected the QU drive. And the QU drive is actually the universal global USB source. So it's all very complicated. But I'm learning it slowly. Then you go back to the standard mix by hitting the channel button down here.